Welcome back to Get Down to Business, the show all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship. Thrilled to kick off this segment with Alejandro Salazar, who is a distinguished figure in strategy consulting and the founder of the premier consulting firm Breakthrough, with over 30 years of experience, might I add, that includes earning a PhD from our very own Northwestern University in Evanston. He has an incredible journey, having advised over 30 CEOs of billion-dollar companies across Latin America, reshaping the region's business landscape. He has a best-selling book. It's called The Emergence Strategy and the Death of Strategic Planning, which invites readers to embrace innovative approaches, sparking a paradigm shift in organizational success. That's exactly what I'm thrilled to talk about with Alejandro Salazar today. Alejandro, welcome to the program.
Thanks, Shalom. Very nice. I'm so happy to be with you and know that I am talking to a lot of people in Chicago.
I know you love Chicago, which is great. So, Alejandro, let's dive in. We only have a few minutes, and I want to introduce our listeners to this concept of emergent strategy. So what is that core concept, and how does it differ from traditional strategic planning?
Great. I mean, it's basically the recognition that strategic planning fails. It's a failure. It's a farce. Plans are really nothing. I mean, plans are basically infatuations, ideas, and strategy is a whole different phenomenon. So the idea is that a strategy, and you may know it from your military experience, a strategy emerges from what you're doing, from clashing with the marketplace. In the military case, I think there's a famous maxim by von Moltke that says that all plans die with the first contact with the enemy. So I think it's the realization that it's really through doing, through reaching awareness and consciousness and mindfulness from the feedback of the market, and then connecting a collective intelligence that resides in any organization, small or big, where the phenomenon of strategy takes place. It emerges from what you're doing, emerges from the market, and that's what I propose, and that's the theory. I mean, it's also very important to talk about a theory, because I think there are a lot of methods, and there wasn't really a theory that connected strategy, the phenomenon of strategy, in that way. That's what I did throughout, 25 years of experience.
Absolutely. That's powerful stuff. And I know in, of course, your book, The Emergent Strategy, you talk about how the most vibrant companies are built on courage and action rather than plans and analysis. Can you elaborate on this and provide some examples of companies that have successfully implemented this approach?
Yeah. Shalom, the essence of strategy, the what of strategy, is choice, hard choice. One, the thing that took me, that made me realize the whole thing that took me to my theory was that plans very, very occasionally deliver a choice, let alone a hard choice. So the hard choice, which means that when you're in a company, you do one thing that is attractive and you give up on a lot of other potentially attractive things, the essence of that process is the essence of strategy. I'm going just to give you many examples. But just to start with popular examples, just look at Apple. Everybody talks about Apple and how Apple, there's a famous moment when somebody at Apple told Steve Jobs to develop a low price version of the iPhone to win in the Chinese market, and he said, I'd rather wait for the Chinese to get rich and buy my product. That's a typical hard choice. When you, for example, develop a retail model and you stick to some categories and give up on a lot of other potentially attractive categories, you're practicing the discipline of choice. When you decide to let go of potentially, for example, to be able to let go even of improvement, a lot of companies are constantly improving, investing in improvements that I call improvements in the direction of disadvantage. All of those different options present permanently to companies. And my claim is that in the strategic planning, companies basically trying to be other companies, trying to follow trends, trying to follow best practices, basically get confused and inhibit their capacity to choose. And in that way, they kill strategy. So for you to practice the discipline of hard choice, which, as I said, is the essence of strategy, you need to do it through an emergent process. You need to do it through learning, through breakthroughs, through discovery, and, of course, through courage. And that's really what my theory is all about.
I'm chatting with the author of a new best-selling book, The Emergent Strategy and the Death of Strategic Planning. That's Alejandro Salazar. And really enjoying this conversation. Alejandro, I've got a lot more to pick your brain on. And I'm curious, how can leaders cultivate a culture of experimentation and learning within their organizations, no matter how big or how small?
I think that the first thing that is that the leaders, if we're talking about the CEO shouldn't see himself or herself as the strategist. I think that's one of the biggest traps, mental traps. I think CEOs are the anchors, the ambassadors of the conversations that the collective intelligence of an organization uses to get to the choices. The real strategist in my story is the organization. So I think that's the first thing, reaching parity, being able to have open conversations, focus on what the company or the organization is doing. I think most of the times in planning, people are focusing on what others are doing, what the trends are, where the technologies are going, and they lose the initiative. I mean, your military experience probably tells you that's actually very wrong, and that's what people do in strategic planning. So I think it's about change of mindset. It's about being able to have a paritarian, open-ended, learning-driven conversations. And then at the moment of when the choices starts to emerge, and when the framing of the real hard choice becomes clear, then I guess CEOs have to be CEOs have to summon the courage. But many times they just have to practice followership. It's not even leadership, but followership. I mean, if the collective intelligence is showing us the direction, the CEO should just tag along. That's kind of a different role, because we're taught that we have this paradigm that the CEO is the strategist in the story. That would be my, I guess, in a short time, my first and most important observation around your question.
Absolutely, Alejandro. This is great. And we know that certainly technology is evolving and advancing quite rapidly. How would you see the role of technology playing in shaping future strategic approaches?
I mean, I write about that in my book. I mean, I don't think artificial intelligence is going to substitute for the collective intelligence of an organization. I think the organization will always be the strategist. I remember this old maxim that said that if you don't want to be replaced by an AI, don't act like one. I think that technology, AI or any other technology, certainly is part of the uncertainty of the market. That thing that you clash against or clash with is part of it. But I think you have to be very careful to understand that most of the technologies that your firm faces may be important, but they aren't strategic. The confusion between important and strategic is a very, very pervasive confusion in strategic planning. Strategic is about things that you have to make choices about. So I guess only if a technology helps you create a distinctive capability for your company, which is critical, because that's where the advantage resides, that technology is strategic. Otherwise, there may be important trends, but you shouldn't be distracted by that. That's kind of my general message on that. I think we live on, remember, the enemy of a strategy is convergence. And technology is a convergence force most of the times. So when people are doing benchmarks and are getting into this rat race and this paranoia, they're basically already out of the strategic path or the strategic thinking. And the first thing they have to do is break away from that.
Well, the book is The Emergent Strategy. And again, we've been chatting with Alejandro Salazar, who again earned his PhD in our very own Northwestern University in Evanston. And it's a great read. And Alejandro, you've got a lot of great advice, and I wish we had more time. But that's why I want to make sure our listeners can get in touch with you so they can learn more about the book. And I guess on that note, where can they find the book and where can they learn more about you?
They can find the book in Amazon. Available all everywhere in the world, The Emergent Strategy. My website, theemergentstrategy.com, and they can also reach me, Alejandro Salazar, in LinkedIn. Post questions and we can open conversations. And certainly a long way from my times at Northwestern, which was a very important time and very treasured time in my life.
Well, we appreciate it. And I look forward to having you back on to talk more about all of those experiences and all the great advice that you have. Leandro, thank you so, so much. We're going to squeeze in a quick break, some headlines, commercials. And when we come back, we've got a lot more small business jobs and entrepreneurship. So don't touch that dial. We'll be right back.